Important things to know are it's transmitted very similarly to the common cold. So the practices that we traditionally know work for that and for flu prevention will work to prevent infection with this as well. Washing hands frequently, not touching your face, staying home if you're sick so that you don't expose other folks to it, keeping your kids out of school if they're sick. First mild symptoms of illness, we're asking people to just be really, really stringent about sort of stepping out of the social sphere and staying home until they don't have any symptoms of being sick anymore. Some of the myths I think that are going around are about masks. So we see a lot of folks wearing masks who are general public, who are outdoors, thinking that that will keep them healthy and prevent the germ from getting in. The fact of the matter is, people who don't wear masks every day for their day job, when they wear masks as a new experience, they usually fiddle with their mask a lot. They readjust it, they reach underneath it to rub their nose, and the more that you're doing that, the more you're actually touching your face. So masks usually are sort of a false sense of security and don't work very well. We will ask people to put masks on if they come into a healthcare facility and they're the ones doing the coughing, because that keeps their own secretions inside the mask instead of letting the droplets from the cough land on surfaces around them. So wearing a mask to protect other people is important, but honestly, if you're sick, instead of going out in the world with a mask, you should stay home instead. I think that there's some concern about limited access to supplies right now. So hand sanitizer is one of those. Alcohol-based, 60% alcohol-based hand sanitizer is effective, but if folks can't get that because the shelves are empty right now, washing people's hands with warm water and soap is absolutely just as effective. I know that people aren't in the habit of washing their hands as often as that they probably should during flu season, which is what we're still in as well, but that is as effective if you can't get hand sanitizer. I think at home, the normal cleaning products that folks would use, if you look on the back of your bottle of disinfectant, it usually has a long list of the types of germs it kills. If it says human coronavirus in it, it's effective for this coronavirus. This is a new one, but the old coronavirus, a lot of folks don't realize that they're very familiar with, is the common cold. The problem with people using disinfectants is they're often not using it in the way that it was intended to be used. It's supposed to be used to wet a surface for a certain amount of minutes. So sometimes people will just get a rag a little bit damp with it and wipe lots of surfaces with that rag. People actually need to read the instructions on the back of the bottle, and so they need to have the surface be cleaned, and then when it's ready to disinfect, to use the product as the instructions say, as well as cleaning horizontal surfaces like tables, desk, countertops, because if somebody coughs, that's where the droplets land. If you have school-age kids who tend to touch everything, cleaning more frequently right now would be a good idea, but it's not that it's a kitchen germ, like, for example, cleaning your counters right after you prepare raw meat, etc. This is more like a cold or a flu. This virus normally only causes mild or moderate symptoms, and people can rest at home and they can become healthy again and recover without any kind of medical intervention. But if you're having shortness of breath, right, if you have a high fever, fatigue, things that would normally cause you to seek care, go ahead and seek that care. We're not asking people to be extra cautious or to utilize their healthcare provider more than they normally would. There isn't a specific medication that they would give someone if they did know that they had this virus. It's all just the normal kind of treatment measures we would do for comfort. So people shouldn't be afraid to seek care, but we're not asking folks to, I guess I would say, overutilize the healthcare system. It's really normal to be anxious in a situation like this, but I think instead of being anxious, people can do a couple things to prepare themselves. The first one is to remember that the vast majority of people recover on their own. Most people do not get very sick with this illness, but the things we can do to prevent it are to wash our hands, to ask other folks to cover their cough, stay home when they're sick, do those normal things that we would do to just keep our immune system strong and healthy, and please be a friend to other folks instead of stigmatizing people.